Samsung is getting ready to release some new high-end smartphones called the Galaxy S24, and they will be powered by a chip called the Exynos 2400. But there's also another chip in the works, the Exynos 1480, which will be used in more budget-friendly phones like the Galaxy A54. What's interesting about the Exynos 1480 is that it's going to have a special graphics processor made by AMD, a well-known company for making high-quality graphics. There were some rumors that Samsung might stop using AMD's technology and make their own graphics, but it looks like they are still working with AMD, and they are bringing AMD's graphics to cheaper phones with the Exynos 1480. This means that even less expensive Samsung phones will have really good graphics thanks to AMD. The Exynos 1480 chip hasn't been tested on a regular phone yet, but that's normal because the first phone it will go into, the Galaxy A55, won't be out for about 6 more months if Samsung follows its usual release schedule. However, we have some information about the chip. It has 8 parts that do the work. 4 of them are faster and run at 2.75 GHz, and the other 4 are a bit slower, running at 2.05 GHz. This is a bit different from the previous Exynos 1380 chip, which had parts running at 2.4 GHz and 2 GHz. The Exynos 1480 also has a special graphics part called the Xclipse 530 GPU. Samsung has a special name for the graphics part in their chips, called Xclipse. They use different numbers to show how powerful the graphics are. For their best chips, like the Exynos 2200, they use Xclipse 9XX, and the next one will be the Xclipse 940. For the less powerful chips in mid-range phones and tablets, they use Xclipse 5XX. The Xclipse 530 is going to be in these mid-range devices. The Xclipse 530 uses older technology compared to the Xclipse 940. The Xclipse 940 is based on a newer technology called RDNA3, while the Xclipse 530 uses RDNA2, which is not as advanced. This means the Xclipse 530 will be less powerful than the Xclipse 940, but we don't have the exact details or numbers to compare them yet. We're not sure if the Xclipse 530 will have a feature called ray tracing, which makes graphics look very realistic, but is demanding on the hardware. Right now, ray tracing is mostly available in very expensive phones from Samsung, Qualcomm, and Apple, so it might not be in the Xclipse 530. However, it's still a big deal that Samsung is using AMD's graphics in a less expensive chip. They should also make sure that the phones or tablets with the Exynos 1480 have good cooling, so the chip doesn't get too hot and slow down its performance. That's it for this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future videos. Thanks and see you next time. Peace out.